The world economy is shifting in a very noticeable way to a situation where there is less use of dirty energy resources and more use of cleaner resources. And the reason for that is because most countries are realizing that the planet is warming and therefore something should be done about it. Secondly, there is a lot of interest in cheaper technologies, cheaper ways of producing energy. And surprisingly, a lot of the cleaner energy sources are now cheaper than dirty energy sources. The right motivation are two. One is that because the politicians are very interested in producing clean energy, you can develop projects much faster. You can get regulation and permitting of new projects much faster than if you were to set up dirty energy projects. For example, I grew up in India, and if you want to build a coal-fired power plant in India, you need 2 or 3 years of permitting process. You have to get the permits, get permission to set up a power plant, get environmental sanctions, and so on. But if you want to start a solar energy project, you can do everything in 3 or 4 months. So many companies are thinking that that is much more profitable than setting up dirty energy projects. Yes, not only carbon emissions, but also what happens when you burn coal and oil is that you get other types of pollution, air pollution. For example, if you go to big cities like Shanghai, Beijing, New Delhi, the part per million, the particulate matter pollution in the air is very high. That leads to lung cancer, that leads to children getting affected with asthma and all kinds of breathing problems. And there is now evidence that if you are exposed to this pollution when you are young, even if you leave the country and go somewhere else, it never goes away. So a lot of governments and policymakers have realized that there are serious dangers with dirty energy. So one problem is climate change and global warming. The other problem is all these other diseases and health problems that come about as a result. So there is a lot of political will to move economies towards a green economy, and therefore you see in COP21 and now in 22, there'll be a lot of discussion about how to move the economy towards a more sustainable energy use profile. See, the capacity issue is very interesting because the big countries have capacity. So like the United States, China, to some extent India have a lot of capacity. But a smaller country like Morocco or Bangladesh or Fiji have less capacity, they have less industry, they have less private sector involvement. So it is possible that those countries will need some help to trigger transition towards clean energy. Once you start the process, then many more things will happen. But it is possible that bigger countries will have to help the smaller countries to start this process in capacity building.
Thank you.